Hey guys, Fourpaws here, and today we're going to be taking a look at champions who counter Irelia. Irelia's abilities are great for top lane, offering her sustain, maneuverability and dueling potential. She is infamous for being one of the most unbalanced champions in the game, and after a bunch of nerfs, she can still hold her own in the lane phase. Thanks to her hit and style ability, she can itemize for defensive bruiser items without sacrificing damage output. So let's take a look at some champions to pick against Irelia. Darius is able to bully many top lane champions, and since Irelia is rather weak during her early game, she will struggle in this lane phase. Darius can zone Irelia with his decimate, and if she enters melee range, he can easily outtrade her. The aim of this lane phase will be to pressure Irelia and try to force her to lose as much creep score and experience as possible. Whenever Irelia activates her hit and style, retaliate with Crippling Strike to reduce her attack speed. A good item to consider rushing is Warden's Mail, as not only will the armor aid you in this lane phase, the passive Cold Steel will reduce Irelia's attack speed further, thus weakening her hitting style. Next up is Jax. You won't be able to outscale Irelia until around level 6. This means that during the early game, a straight up duel to the death could result in either Jax or Irelia dying. So instead, you should play this lane with a farming mindset. Jax scales insanely with items, and against Irelia, you can win most trades if you play reactively rather than aggressively. Focus on farming until Irelia initiates a trade onto you, wait for her hit and style before popping Counter-Strike, and then while she is stunned, land another auto-attack and leap away. Obviously not all trades will go as perfectly as this, however as long as you save your Counter-Strike to dodge hit and style, you should be fine. At around level 11, you should be able to out-duel the Irelia as long as she didn't have a great laning phase. Malphite is another good choice. Malphite doesn't have a lot of kill potential against Irelia, so play passively during the early levels. After picking up some tanky items, an example Warden's Mail, Irelia should not be able to kill you. Farming is your goal in this lane phase. From the lane phase to the end game, Malphite should be frustrating for the Irelia player due to his huge AoE attack speed debuff from his Ground Slam ability. Furthermore, Irelia has a huge amount of tenacity due to her passive, which makes crowd control not very effective on her. However, tenacity does not affect knockups, which makes Malphite's unstoppable force useful for pinning her down. As Renekton, you should be able to bully Irelia in a similar way to Darius. Renekton's lane phase is extremely powerful, and in the majority of games, Irelia should simply be denied. Make sure to punish her during the early game, as this is where the power gap will be at its greatest. To deal with Irelia's hit and style, aim for short burst trades. Cancelling your auto-attack animations whilst trading will be crucial, as this minimises the time Irelia has to land empowered auto-attacks onto you. Aim to slice onto her, auto-attack, and as the damage lands, cancel the animation with an empowered Ruthless Predator, followed by an auto-attack into an empowered called the Meek, and then dash away. It's also worth noting that you should not attempt to trade without your cooldowns, and you should also try to wait for a full rage bar. Otherwise, look to purchase items such as Sunfire Cape, as it will give you armor to help with her auto-attacks, and a nice chunk of health which will soak her true damage. This lane phase should be a breeze. Taking Teemo allows for a very easy early game. Irelia should struggle to do anything without the help from a jungler during the early levels. Constantly poke down at Irelia with auto attacks, and try to zone her away from the minions. During trades, whenever Irelia uses hit and style, use your blinding dart and start to kite her. Also, it's worth mentioning that you should try to not use your blinding dart offensively, as without being blinded, Irelia will most likely outtrade Teemo. Otherwise, there isn't much more to this lane, just poke Irelia down and last hit. And finally we get to Udyr. Udyr has been a known Irelia counter for a long time now, and with his recent buffs he can still outperform Irelia. To start, Irelia will not be able to trade Udyr due to his Tiger Stance will destroy her in the early levels. Otherwise, Turtle Stance will aid with matching Irelia's sustain, and Bear Stance will help with chasing and dueling her. Udyr should have total lane control in this matchup. Warden's Mail is a nice item for this lane phase, as previously mentioned, but on Udyr especially, this item is very viable, as are its potential upgrades, Frozen Heart or Randuin's Omen. My general tip for laning against Irelia is to be careful of a gap closing with Blade Surge. As Blade Surge's cooldown resets if it deals a killing blow, Irelia can navigate around the lane by last hitting minions, thus she might be able to reach you from a rather far distance. Watch your friendly minion's health bars to know when she might be trying this trick, so she won't catch you out. Overall, Irelia isn't very strong in the lane phase, so hopefully this video will help you shut her down. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like down below, and as always, feel free to come check out my channel How to Top Lane if you want to further improve yourself as a player. For the next episode of Countered, we'll cover the most liked champion in the comments below, so please give us your suggestion. Until next time, take care guys.